Exactly the same thing on an acoustic guitar now. This one, Naomi. A lot of you write your own songs, right? And I always say that my songs are like my children. Right? I like them all. Some are popular, some nobody likes, and that's okay. But this one's my problem child, but because everybody tonight is sticking their neck out and trying something new, they tell our spirit, so I'm gonna introduce myself with my problem child, and this song is called Trickster. some music from my home. The indigenous people of the south-facing mountain slopes of Austria. Southern Austria, Carinthia. The joke about my region in Austria is that if you get two of us together, we have a chorus. We like to sing. And this song is something I grew up with. And I was kind of inspired by Miroslav, who always, you know, arranges beautiful folk songs from his home. And when COVID hit and I couldn't go home, I arranged this song. And it's called It's Quiet Around the Lake, Isustu Umansi. To my heart since I was a student here. Still, most of you hear me downstairs in B200 more than you hear me with a guitar. I like to bang on things, obviously. This next song, I said all my songs are like my kids and I like them. This is my favorite. You're not supposed to have favorites with your kids, but you kind of do. This is my favorite. It's called Aynalar Arasında, which is Turkish for between the mirrors. In Istanbul, at the old airport, there used to be a place where you could be between two mirrors. And I thought that was a neat analogy for my own midlife crisis. So this is Aynalar Arasında, between the mirrors. Thank you. got more goodness to come. I just wanted to extend my huge thank you to the guitar program, School of Music, for making this happen. And also Miroslav and Stuart Fox, who's here today too, who basically got this going. So thank you.
Sorry guys, no rock and roll tonight. Save that for Friday. So we're all very happy to be here. We're all also graduates of this program, so it's really wonderful for me. I'm the most recent one. So a lot of you guys know me as I'm the styles player, the session player, and the studio technician and all that, so you're not getting any of that tonight. When I looked at the program, my tendency is to find that thing, since I play lots of different kinds of music that nobody else is doing, and do that. So what y'all are getting from me tonight is a bunch of music that I've never played before. I'm from a very small village in New Mexico called Corrales. I'm Mexican, as some of you know. And I also, during the pandemic, couldn't go home, so I wrote home. And that's what this is. Thank you.
Thank you. The greatest thing
I don't know what kind of cruel joke it is asking us to play after that. But I've been very happy to just sit back there and allow that to continue for a couple hours. So it's occurred to me, it's really hard to for me to play without contextualizing my work a little bit, because y'all are so used to hearing me as a teacher, so it's hard for me not to do a little of that. It occurs to me in sort of the commonality between all of us, we're all from very, very different backgrounds. So we're all very deeply connected to our roots musically and our sort of sense of ancestry and lineage. And it's a wonderful thing for me to be here downstream from Miroslav, who's downstream from Stuart, and there's continuity in what we do, even though we're all very different. So some of you who studied with me know that I come from a similar lineage that comes from the desert in New Mexico, and I'm sharing bits of that with you tonight. The first thing I just shared with you was pastoral, about the land, and this is about, or a gift from my father, who taught me basically everything I know, and I've been very happy to pass on to y'all the musical and spiritual lessons that he shared with me when I was growing up. So this is something that he wrote. I don't even know how to tell the story of this song. He wrote when he was in LA working. He was an incredible guitarist. Spent a little time in LA, realized he preferred the desert, and if you wanted to learn from him, you had to go to the desert and hang out with him and check out what he was about out there. So this is a piece of music that I literally have to ask the ancestors if it's okay to play. Sometimes it goes great, and other times, you know. So this is a piece called, well, I'll just sort of talk about what we're gonna do so we can go from one thing to the next. So this is sort of a land acknowledgement. It's a land acknowledgement in terms of my roots from my father. And he passed in 2016, actually, just about a year ago, this past Saturday. And the next thing that I'll play after that is a land acknowledgement in terms of a mythology that we have. And that mythology has to do with the way that Mexican women in particular, Mexican American women, carry trauma forward through storytelling. So, story from my father, and then a repurposing of the Llorona story as one of survival instead of one of loss. This is Isla Vista. I also, in the middle of giving an acknowledgement, I have to thank my good friend Trevor Williams for handling all the projections on short notice. He found out he was doing this a couple days ago. He's never been here before, so it's a lot to ask someone to jump into all this. He's been very gracious, so thank you. All right, let's see if they say yes. Thank you. Let me apple it up, everybody. So that's what it was like hanging out around the house when I was a kid. So it was going down. It's a big shoes to fill. So I thought a lot about songwriting. I talked to y'all a lot about songwriting. You guys know I have some feelings about how that's supposed to go. And one of those feelings is that we've kind of heard all the songs, we've written all the songs, we know what songs are. So we don't have to do the whole songness of it, if that makes sense. So I would like to think about this, or I tend to think about this. Again, I'm from the desert, so I'm gonna use some desert imagery. You know, every 7 years we have the cicadas that come out and they make the sounds and they're very present. And then they leave behind these shells. And we actually don't see the cicadas too much because they're up in the trees, right? But you see the shells, and you can tell from the husk of what was there, what was actually in. You don't need to see the whole bug to know what it was. So as you're listening, I would encourage you to think about the approach to song that I take as being sort of like the shell. We're just going to give you the gesture. This is a song called Absolution. She said, okay. Trevor, I need you to tell me when we're rolling and I can't see.
All right, here we go.
Okay, thanks. Okay. She said, come. She said, come to the water's edge. I will take away your sins. Even though I know you're bearing me, the weight you hold within. And she swept into the river, and the waters turned to blood. Coursed out into the ocean, where her bones became a mud. Oh, her bones became a mud. The story. Tell you when you're younger what your fate will likely be. 'Cause when I was a
There's no quarter here. There's no quarter. There's no quarter. There's no quarter here. There's no quarter. There's no quarter. There's no quarter here. I cast you out of this place. 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 I 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 cast you out of this place.
Before we do that, I wanted to make an acknowledgement. This guitar program, which is really flourishing, and we're just having such a good time, and enjoying the diversity of all of the music and all of the students that we have. It started in 1974 by my teacher, who is right here tonight, and I just wanted to give him acknowledgement. That's Stuart Fox. I also want to thank our dean, Volker Strebel, for being here and for spending his evening with us. It's very kind of you. I hope you're enjoying it. And we're going to play now a little bit of film music for you from a combination of some of my favorite artists, the great director Wim Wenders, and musician, guitarist Ry Cooder. These are a couple of pieces from a film that's called Paris, Texas. And here we go.
Thank you. and it's just across the borderline. And when it's time to take your turn, here's a lesson that you must learn. You could lose more than you. It's just across the borderline. And when it's time to take your turn, here's a lesson that you must learn. You could lose more than you ever hope to find. You could lose.
Thank you.
music from my home, traditional stuff. And we heard a lot of like Western-ish and adjacent music. And I'm going to come out with a gross generalization, but Western music in general, like, we like to stick notes and different pitches on top of each other. Whereas in West Africa, in that tradition, they put different rhythms on top of each other. That's how they generate colors. Anyway, this is a gross generalization, but it's also not wrong. So what we tried to do with this one is a cult piece by the Gebe cult. It's very short and sweet, and usually it's a lead drum and a few, two bells and two supporting drums. And what we did here is we put all the supporting drums on guitars. And I love that everybody just said, yep, let's do it. Even though it might not be your métier, but we did pull it off, and it's a bit of a risk we're taking today.